So how do you get a fit colleague to represent the world? What are they doing about it? So I look back at some of the original press statements last September from Councillor Fowkes. And to be fair, throughout Councillor Fowkes' press statements and comments on the Council website on the 22nd of September, list all the reports that have been highlighted by Alec Bonowski. And in summary, he says, what any one of these reports would have been enough to sound very loud warning bells, but on Wirral we appear to have accepted practices as normal as other councils would see as abnormal. But I'm grateful that that was included in the press statements at the time, and I'm trying to measure everything that has happened since. I also went rooting around for my original copy of the report into Cheshire Lines. And in the Cheshire Lines report, there was a headline, Weak Corporate Governance. And in that, it talked about there is a pattern of non-compliance with the council's own constitutional requirements and procedures. Chief officers have not always discharged their roles and responsibilities effectively. And it did go on to say, repeated failures by chief officers to consult colleagues on draft reports where appropriate and to seek advice from council statutory officers when required. So that's a number of years ago. Whether I have not kept my eye on the ball, but we've been trying to address things, or various officers have tried to address things, and we're looking for a climate in which members and officers are frank, candid friends, and where our staff can speak to us and things can be followed up. So what I'm looking for in the end is the result of that work that was put in, that initiative that was taken by the previous leader, where about 1,000, when the staff went to the two sessions at Hume Hall and in the floor of the inn, the staff went in batches, if you forgive the term, were asked to give their views, and since then I think probably 1,000 staff have put comments in. But I want to know, how do we distill those comments? How do we find out how our staff see us? How do we find out that our staff trust us to put it right? In section 21 and 29 of the plan, 21 talks about the need to further develop corporate working. And section 29 of the action plan talks about this question of culture. And in the columns, both are described as the need to develop a programme of activities and deliver a programme. What we need to get our hands on as members is